Use headphones for best experience. Thanks for your fantastic support, and thank you for supporting me on Tingles app. Hi, welcome to another video. First, I'd like to thank you so much that you take your time and comment on my videos, and it really warms my heart. So please keep commenting. I appreciate it so much. Today's video, I have this atlas. It's an old atlas, as you might see, as you might guess from the look of the cover. It's called Geografisk Atlas för Allmänna Läroverk. It's a Swedish old atlas. And on the last page you can read that it's from 1895. Or this text is written. Maybe 1 year or a couple of years later this was printed, I guess. And we're just gonna flip through the pages and I'll read something from this map. Just want to show you style of this map and the design. I think it's really beautiful. Old maps can be really beautiful. Maybe we can take a look at some continent areas of the world that haven't been seen so much yet in my videos. Let's see what we can find. So here's the content, innehåll. Västra halvklotet, östra halvklotet. A lot of Nordic countries here in the beginning. Europe, British Isles. Europe again, South Europe, Mediterranean, West Mediterranean, East Mediterranean, and then we jump to Canada, US, Mexico, Central America, and then we're back, Switzerland and North Italy. And again, we're back in North America and also South America. And then we have Africa, Australia, Asia again. So this part of Asia is mostly Middle East here. Then we have East Asia. The last pages. But if we take a look at the pages from 30 to 34, maybe. Yeah, then North America. It says Norra America. Bikarta, Nordatlantiska staten. On page 31 to 32 we have Södra Amerika, bikartor, Andiska höglandet, Brasiliens kustland. On page 33 we have Västra och Inre Sudan med Övre Guinea, Ekvatorial och Sydafrika, bikarta, Kongoflodens nedersta lopp. Page 34 we have Afrika, bikarta, Nilens källsjöar. Sounds interesting to me. So it's the source lakes, or yeah, like the source of the Nile, biggest or longest river in the world. Let's turn to page 30. Marocko, Nordafrika. Actually, I would like to show you something. This magnifying glass. Sahara Desert, Medelhavet, Egypt. Not spelled like this in Swedish any longer. There must be an O synen. Victoria och Kerebe sjön, Kerebe Lake. And it's one of the sources to the Nile. This is the Nile. River, don't you think? Here we have Congo Staten. Adrovimi. So this was North Africa on this map. We have another label here. Let's take a closer look. This is actually a name I haven't heard before, looking at this map. Okay, I missed something. I have to take another look at the first letter. See the two dots? over the A letter. It's the same here as in the spelling of Egyptian, like that I mentioned earlier. First I didn't see these two dots because they were like hidden in the landscape, the mountains and the river. But it's the letter A here again, so we would write it in a more modern way, we would replace it with the E. So it's Equatorial Africa, Equatorial Africa. Spelled with the A letter at the beginning. Equator. And with the Q letter, second, following the A letter. So today, these two letters are replaced with the E and the K. I think in Swedish there was a major change in the spelling around 1905 or something like that. A lot of the old-fashioned way of spelling things were replaced by modern. It would resemble the way you were speaking more. So a lot of strange. Here we also have an old type of spelling, Buktan, with a G letter. Now it's spelled with a K. So this is an old spelling as well, and here as well, Övre Guinea, spelled with an F letter. 10 years later it should be replaced by the V letter, Övre, because I guess no one did pronounce it Övre. Gambian. Sounds like a combination of Senegal and Gambia. Senegambian. Sierra Leone. Liberia. Elfenbenskust. Guldkusten, Beninviken, here we also have one of the longest rivers in Africa, the Niger River. Franska Kongo, Angola, Valfiskviken, Swedish name for this bay here says whale. Goda Hopps, Udden, Kaplandet, Orange. Transvaal, this is written so tiny, I have to check what it says. Someone has actually underlined it. Guess that person finds some importance here. Sounds almost like Del Agua, water. Viken is bay, so the bay of water, Del Agua. Could that be Portuguese or Spanish? Yes, Mozambique was Portuguese. But it's like a Swedish way of spelling it, but I haven't seen it before, the spelling of Del Agua. And what's this? It looks like it says Umatsilas. Umatsilas. It's a bit messy here. with a border right over this first letter, but looks like it said Umtsilas Rike. And Rike, that's like country or kingdom. Like, you know, Sverige, Sweden. In Swedish it's called Sverige. And that's originally that means Svea Rike. And Rike is kingdom and Svea is, well, now today Svea is a name. You can have like a person name. It can be called Svea, it's a female name, but Rike, the second part of the name, means country, kingdom. And I guess we will do the same as we did with kind of missed this part of the continent. Let's take a closer look here as well. This whole area is called Sudan. And here it said Egyptiska Sudan. I guess this is what Sudan today. South Sudan and Sudan. And here also it says Inre Sudan, the inner. This wrong. Cop. Guarda fui. This part of the continent is referred to as Så i Sydafrika. Today, South Africa is a country. Of the Nile, drainage area of the Nile, Nilens, Shellområde, Equatoria, Uganda, Unyoro, Victoria, Nyanza eller Kerewe sjön. Distance for eller distance for sjön lik. Och Kerewe somewhere that Lake Victoria is the second biggest freshwater lake in the world after Lake Superior. Let's take a look at some other map. Here we have South America. Brazilian. By far biggest country in South America. Almost all the way to Rio de la Plata. Almost to the Andes. The Amazonas rainforest, major part of it is in Brazil. Here we have the Amazon River. Could be the second longest river in the world after the Nile. I think so. It also depends on how you measure, because I guess the Amazon River has a lot of smaller rivers. This area of the river. system of rivers is bigger. This huge drainage basin. Sometimes called the lungs of the earth. Mato Grosso, Goiás, Bahia, Minas Gerais. São Paulo, Santos, Rio de Janeiro, Victoria, Bahia, Rio, São Francisco. See, it starts with the rivers, the system of rivers here. This tropical area. Another big river in South America is Paraná. Interesting, I guess Paraná or some river that later emerged into Paraná starts really close to the Atlantic coast, but instead of reaching the Atlantic coast the shortest way takes a long way through Paraná River. Paraguay River here, and eventually connects with the Uruguay River here, and ends up in Rio de la Plata, the capitals, Buenos Aires, Argentina. Montevideo, capital of Uruguay. It's a more detailed map of most populated area of Brazil, I guess. I just read that I've always known that the Queen of Sweden, she's really, if you want to listen to natural ASMR person, unintentional ASMR person, search for Queen Silvia of Sweden. That's like the way I learned about ASMR. Listening to her, the interviews of her. But anyway, I just was curious to know where she was born, because I knew she was born in Brazil somewhere, but I had no idea where. But I did a quick search and got the information that it was here somewhere. The middle of the state of São Paulo. I guess here, close to the Paraná River. This is the state of Paraná. Maybe these states and a lot of names. things, of course, could have changed since 1885. No, 1895, but this is what it says on this map. Paraná, Santa Catarina, Rio Grande do Sul. Sebastião, Rio de Janeiro, or yes, Rio de Janeiro, probably. Minas Gerais, Espírito Santo. The Rio, San Francisco, I guess. Let's take a closer look. I can't read this. Too tiny. Rio. Rio San Francisco. Ah, there it is. Oh. It's Rio San Francisco. Yes, these islands that I mentioned in one of my latest videos. Fernando, Noronha. So here, I guess they're using this time zone that's not used by so many people, the UTC minus 2, I think. That was a quick look at Africa and also Brazil. I guess that's it for today. But there are lots of really nice maps in this atlas that we can take a look at eventually. idea about sometime. Thank you so much.